Hello and welcome to Bemenji Drive. I'm your host, David Anark, and as many of you know or may know, Bemenji gave us a Christmas present, and that is they have updated the game to version 0.8. I have not even looked at it, so we're going to look at it together. In fact, I have a computer sitting off to the side so that I can scroll through and see what the different changes are. But one of the things I noticed as soon as I got into the game, the menu now has a little clicky sound when you point to the different things. So there you go. It's the little things. All right. Holy cow. Okay, they have completely revamped the garage. Wow, look at that. Unnecessary components are removed to make this an excellent dirt racer. Oh. Oh, look at there. It even has a price. Okay, so what are the, oh, these are the different, look at this. Wow, so okay, so there's a cost involved. It gives you the little information detail here in the middle. Tells you the drivetrain, transmission, the derby class, interesting. Torque, power, all this other kind of stuff down here. And so you can cycle through these. Oh, look at that. That is so cool. Okay, so like what if I jump over here? Okay, like here's the Rose Sport. Okay, so it still says Derby class. I was just curious to see. I mean, if you're doing like, or if like if you're doing the drag version, you know, why is it still telling me what the Derby class is? But anyway, that's just some little, you know, thing. $46,000. So over here, oh, why did it go 23, 23, 22? Okay, wait, what? I'm very confused. Okay, oh, so I see. It works its way backwards. That's weird. Huh. Okay. Anyway. Okay. This is the car I'm looking at. This is the next car in line. Okay, I got you. That's a little confusing. Oh, cool. So you can do this a couple of different ways. Oh, look. You can scroll through this way without making any noise. Shh. Anyway. $136,000. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. 85, 84. All right, so obviously money is going to come into play here at some point in the game. Configure and save your own cars. Very cool. So you can change the settings of the car and then save that as your own personal vehicle. Here's the thing with parts. Again, I can right-click and drag around. Now, this is interesting. Alternate two-tone. It's blue. Oh, look at that. Oh, that is cool. Okay, so then the question is, how do I change the top color? If that's the base color, detail palette 1, detail palette 2. Okay, so let's just see. If I go here and we click vibrant red, I don't see anything that turned anything red on this one. Let's do green. Okay, there we go. So with the two-tone, you can choose the base color up here, which is, in this case, the stripe. And then on this particular vehicle, detail palette 1 is... Okay, that seems to be a little glitchy, I guess. I'm very confused. Anyway, oh, look down here, user. So I guess you can add user colors if you want to add user colors. Very cool. So two-tone paint jobs in certain vehicles. Notice the things are a little off here. So I don't know if like the default resolution needs to be bumped up. Right now I'm running 720p, but you notice certain things look like they're getting kind of cut off. So I don't know. We'll see. Here is, oh, look at there, photo camera view. So I can set this up and then I can snap a picture. Oh, how cute. And then I can share that or I can upload it to a media server. So there you go. All right. Now I can also, this is where I can save my car. If I want to save that particular look and feel of the car. So that's very cool. So now if I wanted to, I could pick one of these, right? And we can go to the paint jobs. No, why is this car? Why are you doing that? Okay, there's some weird glitches. Or I'm an idiot and don't know how this works. Oh, okay, so here's the bolide. I want this car. Now, I want to paint this car. What's this do? No. Oh my gosh, every time it goes to the. Okay, that's. Wow, I'm already discovering some things that are a bit of a problem. All right. Escape. I don't want to save my car. Exit. Thank you. Okay, well, I spent way too long in the garage. So, just to let you know, the garage has some glitches, and we'll show some of that. Okay, so the first thing we do is let's see. Notice that we have, there's a quick play menu here, and inside quick play, you can choose a level. So let's just say, so, did we not get a new map? Maybe we didn't get a new map. Okay, anyway, let's just try this one. And there are, I guess there's no settings for that one. Select the layout. Oh, look at that. That's pretty cool. So I'm gonna do rally cross sprint, and then the vehicle that you want to spawn in here. Let's do rally, and then that's just some information. All right, so there we are. All right, so quick play with we got hot lapping. Ooh, a nice sound when you pass through a checkpoint. You catch that? That's nice. I like that because that is an audio clue. Hello. Wow, good job. With the audio clue, because sometimes before, oh my gosh, you've got to be kidding me. I guess I can reset. Of course not. I'm a doof. Anyway, before, when you go through, or you thought you went through the checkpoint, I can't drive. All right, I have to reset. Before, when you went through the checkpoint, or thought you went through the checkpoint, you wouldn't actually know. And so sometimes you'd think you would skirt right through a checkpoint, but actually you missed it. And you wouldn't know until you got to the next checkpoint that wasn't lit up. So nice to have a sound associated with it. We do have a new campaign. It's called A Rocky Start. Ooh, look at this. Oh, that's cool. All right, so the campaigns now have an intro. I'm assuming at some point they will have voice actors doing the voice work. Oh my gosh, my brain's just not working. Okay, so I guess, I don't know. What is my goal to crash into this car? Yep. Okay. So I'm not supposed to pancake myself, but I pancaked myself. You're not supposed to fall off yourself. Oh, okay. Yeah, you need to make that way more clear. That's funny. They're playing the game. All right, this will be awesome. Remember to hit it quick, but not too quick. Don't pancake yourself on the rocks. That does not say don't go over the edge yourself. Just gonna throw that out there. All right. So let's go. Oh, that was easy. Okay. Oh, I love the oh, that's it. Oh, look at that. Oh, this is cool. This is neat. I like this a lot. Check your phone. There's finally some cool stuff happening here. Yes. Press J to show the map with available missions. Rewards. Okay. So let's see what missions. Oh, look at this. Travel as far as you can with only the steering. No. Oh, I have to point it. Okay. So this one is Dusty Race. Race against an opponent across varied terrain. Parts run delivery. Help deliver parts to a location for a friend. Oh, this is cool. Okay. There's a green circle. Oh, and there are arrows on the road pointing the direction to your mission. Oh, this is cool. So wait. Oh, well, no, I probably can't change cars, can I? No. Okay, because I'm actually in a scenario. No. Oh, yeah, that's fine. Sure. Okay. I press enter. No. How do I start the race? Oh. Travel as far as you can with only steering. Sure. How bad could this go? Oh. Oh, this is so cool. Got a little competition for you. Whoever can make it furthest from here wins. Okay, not quite. You won't get bored without brakes, gears, or gas. No brakes. Nope, no brakes. I mean, zigzag or drive into the dirt if you have to, or hit a tree. Okay. I guess I have to click start. Start. Okay. Holy cow. Oh my gosh. And I can't use brakes? Oh yeah, I'm hosed. I'm just gonna throw that out there. Okay. So this one, it's all about distance. So really, speed is not the key, it's the distance. All right, so I think we'll be okay. It's gonna be interesting getting around this hairpin. Oh, gotta be careful. Careful, careful. Well, I have a bad feeling about this, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I've managed to. Holy cow. But I will tell you, this is an awesome idea for a scenario. Very cool idea for a game. I'm definitely listing to the left due to my crazy antics up above. Oh, now I busted my tire. That's okay. We got this. It's a piece of cake. All we're doing is coasting. Well, I managed to pretty much take care of any kind of speed. Ooh, this could actually work against me, huh? So I'm a little over halfway, and here's my problem. I could end up coasting to a stop. No. Oh, I absolutely. Okay, so now what? Ah. Not even close. Give it another shot. I'm sure you can do better than that. Okay, so you can skip these by hitting the numpad 9, which I just did. All right, so let's try this again. This time I'll just let it roll. Roll with it, baby. All right, here we go. There we go. Oop, you want to stay on the road? No, don't get sideways. There we go. There we go. All right, so it's going to get a little funky down here. There we go. That's okay. That's all right. We're still rolling. All right. Yeah, that's pretty cool. They picked a place where using the gravity actually can help you in terms of, it's got some flat areas, it's got some not so flat areas. I'm guessing, though, there's probably gonna be something steep up here, although I guess maybe not, because, I mean, heck, we're gonna make it. We made it. Oh, there you are. I should just crash right into you. Where? Hip check. Oh, I can just keep on going? Sweet. All right, well, fine. I say we keep on going. Oh, get around here. Okay, this will be about the end just because. So can I? Well, this can. Oh, is that still? Yeah, that still counts. Cool. Well, I was hoping that that little dip was going to give me a little extra oomph, but no, it's not. All right, there we go. 1.2 miles. 1.02 miles. Except I'm still. There we go. Ah, look at there. That's cool. I like that a lot. The blue arrows showing you where to go to get to the mission itself. Very, very cool. Okay. I'll let you guys play around with those, or I'll do the full thing in another video. Oh, I forgot. Man, I forgot all about this. They changed the click wheel that comes up when you hit escape, so you can do a lot more using a controller. So there's a way to turn on couplers. You can, here's manage your car. You can remove this particular car. You can set that as the home spot. So that restores. No, I take that back. That restores it to the home position. I didn't actually set a home position. Interesting. Fun stuff. Oh, look at this. So I can set the truck on fire, but then I can extinguish the fire. That's cool. That is very cool. Oh my gosh. Okay, so then there's other stuff you can do with the powertrain. Okay, I hate that I have to keep hitting escape. Oh, no, I don't. I could left right click to go back. Okay. There's electrics. Oh, you can, so you can do, you know, signals, fog lights, that kind of stuff. Couplers. So I attach all, detach all, toggle. That's interesting. Okay, so let's look at that in terms of new, some new vehicles that we get. So here is our travel trailer. And let's take a look inside, shall we? Let's go in the door here. Let's see what we've got. So if we go inside, ooh, look at this. Okay, wait a minute. How are there? Okay, what on earth? I guess this would be a closet, because what else are you gonna put there? Oh, and that's the, okay. So then here is the bathroom. Look at that, very nice. I know I'm like way, there we go. Let's get up to more like person height. Oh, actually, I think I'm still a little short. Look at that. The interior is very nice. We have the fridge. There's nothing in the fridge. Figures. Oh, this is cool. Man. Wow, they did a good job. Okay, travel trailer that size, but only two propane tanks. Just gonna throw that out there. But anyway, all right, so this says the landing gear. Let me see what that does. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so if I come back over here, so let's do couplers, attach all. That doesn't do anything that way. I thought maybe it would like automatically figure out a way to attach everybody, but no. All right, so let's come up here. There we go. All right, we've got our travel trailer. Look at there, our white truck with our white trailer. Oh my. Whoa-ho-ho. A little funky, huh? I can't see this way. Whoops. Pretty sure we just drove off a cliff. There we go. Caravanning across Utah, USA. I'm not really paying attention to where I'm going. I don't really care. I'm not in a. Oh, this is not Utah. I forgot. I'm sorry. I'm in Crimson Valley. Oh, nice spin over. However, the trailer is toast. Let it go. All right. So we have the traffic trailer. And nice work on the bottom too, by the way. Let's see, it's gonna be too far. Let's pull this over. Oh, okay. I was trying to. Well, that's one way to do it. That's not what I had in mind. But you know what? When all else fails, You didn't want a kitchen, did you? We're gonna do a little bit of rearranging here. We're redecorating your travel trailer. In my head, what I'm trying to do, there we go. That's what I was trying to do.
You are nothing but a shell of yourself. Pull yourself together, man.
All right. Anyhow, there's the travel trailer. All right, we also get another vehicle, and that is the Bruckle LeGrand. So there we go. I was just curious to see, is there a price? Nope. Okay. So manufactured between 84 and 88, and it is a very 80s looking car. I mean, seriously. Wow. That's very, All right. So I'll tell you what, let's get in, take a look around. Oh my gosh, look at that. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Cassette player. Oh my gosh, look at there. The awesome power windows, power locks. We are uptown, folks. I love the center-mounted rear brake light. Very nice. Okay, so. Let's just see here. Yeah. Let's go. I say we tow this bad boy over the edge, because that's what we do. Oops, I missed. Sorry. My brain's not working. I'm all conflustered from the craziness. There. You attached yet? You seem pretty attached to me. Let's ride. Off the cliff we go. Sorta. Oop. Can't see anything. I can't see a thing. Oh. What is the matter with you? Right here. It appears we're not going anywhere. Wow. Epic fail. Okay. Oh my gosh, really? There we go. I think the travel trailer would push the car. Holy cow. The travel trailer is completely destroyed. Oh my gosh. That's awesome. However, not really the effect I was looking for. Check this bad boy out. All right. Discharge the chute. I can't see my FPS is in the way. Is that a Q? No, of course it's not. Oh, yeah, there we go. Look at that. Awesome. Okay, so I managed to squeeze the 800 series into the back of this truck. Tell you the truth, I'm not exactly sure if that it's not, attached. So, we're just going to see what happens. There we go. All right. Sorry, because I'm an idiot. That's what we're going to assume. All right. I have no idea what this is going to do, but I tell you what we're going to do is this. Oh! Okay, well, that didn't really work the way I expected. Main engine broken. Main engine. That's very interesting. So does that mean we're going to have vehicles with multiple engines, perhaps? Wow. Well, we're still coming down. Whoa, there's some weird artifacting or something going on. What was that? Oh, look at this. The car in the box, man. That is great. Yeah, I gotta do this. Oh my gosh. That is fantastic. I got your car, lady. There you go. Oh my goodness. That is just ugly. Alright, they added a new street cleaning skin for the pigeon. I'll be honest, I thought that was already a thing, so I guess not. I don't know. Didn't realize the pigeon wasn't already a street cleaner. This shows you how much I pay attention. They added this very cool... I'm going to put this in. Stop the thing. All right, so they added a drag version, but check out the freaking hood. Oh my gosh, that is awesome. That is so cool, man. I love it. I love it. I love it. All right, let's get in and see what this, oops, see what this bad boy can do. Probably not a lot with me, but that's okay. Wow. Holy smokes. That's what happens, boys and girls, when you're in a car that has way too much power, you're not accustomed to, and you slam your foot down on the gas. Wow. Oh my gosh. That is crazy. All right, here we go. We have the roamer. Now, first of all, I figured out how to turn this on. I feel like an idiot. If you go to the vehicle config and you drop down frame and then you drop down body, then it's got navigation unit. And you either enable it or it's empty. When you enable it, there you go. You now have in-car GPS. So that is very cool. The other thing that this vehicle has is I enabled a snorkel. So what that should let me do is actually go into, let's see, I'm way up here. So I'll get down to where there's water and then I'll show you what the snorkel does. All right, I had to change maps, basically so I could find a place where the snorkel would actually be useful. All right, so here's essentially what the snorkel does. If we roll up into the water, normally this is where your engine would start to get waterlogged, right? Because your engine and your exhaust are under the water. However, with the snorkel attachment, that lets you go much deeper into the water. You basically should be able to go as deep as the snorkel. There you go, flooding the engine. As soon as I fell off that edge, the snorkel went under and boom, there you go. So then you're hydrolocked. So that is very, very cool. I think you should be able to have a snorkel on all vehicles. I'm going to suggest that to the devs. Make every vehicle have the ability to have a snorkel because that is awesome. All right, so let's see. Real quick. They improve some stuff with replay. I have never used replay in BeamNG. Probably something I need to do at some point, just so we can play around with that and see what replay does. Now they supposedly they fixed AI. So let's check that out. Let's check out AI. All right, so they've changed some things with AI, and they have a different thing. They have new settings in here. If it has a split road, I believe that means this is where it forces AI to try to stay in the lane, I think. We'll play with that and see what happens. You can also set a risk mode, and the higher the risk, the more daring the AI will be. And I don't know what the max is. I guess, oh, I don't know. I have no idea what all this means. Okay, so 1.44 is the highest risk amount. I don't know. Let's just see what happens. Of course, you can set the speed as it had before. So if I tell it to, and if I guess we just tell it to flee. Okay, so now it's going to try to get away from me. Let's see what happens here. So supposedly, oops. Let me get back over here. Okay, so supposedly while it's fleeing, with the split road, okay, so I did split road off. So does that mean it's willing to drive all over the place? Or does that mean it's gonna, I'm not sure what's what. Let's find out. Now, I also set that risk for the truck at 1.44, so I have no idea what that means. It could be driving all over the place. So far, it actually seems to be adhering to the lane with split road. Oh wait, yeah. Oh, what, I have split road on. I'm sorry. So yeah, so it is forcing it, I believe, to stay in its lane. All right, so let's see if what happens if we turn that off. All right, so now I did split road off, and yeah, it just crossed over. No, it didn't. Or did it? Oh yes, see, it is crossing over the center line. That's very cool. That is very cool. So you can force the AI to stay in its lane or let it drive, you know, willy-nilly all over the road. That is cool. Oh, look at that. That was beautiful. Too bad that was not a scenario, man. That was great. That was one of the most perfect catch the bad guy endings I've ever done. That was awesome. All right, so anyway, there you go. Holy cow. Okay, here we go. They've also... Man. I can't drive and read at the same time, which you're not supposed to. So there you go. They've made all kinds of updates and changes. You can get that from the dev blog, which basically that's going to be at blog.beamng.com/blog. And you can check the updates for 0.8. And a lot of it is, like I said, there's a lot of cosmetic things. But they did add, as we saw in the campaign, they've added the ability to create or add in comic cutscenes. So I think that's pretty cool. So hopefully some of you really creative folks out there will add those to your games. And those comic cutscenes are available in scenarios and in campaigns. So very, very cool. I have no idea where the bad guy went. I don't care. We're just going to fly through the woods. Yahoo! So there you go. Lots of updates, lots of changes. We've taken a look at some of those, but very, very cool. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.